Welcome back, my friends, all about Avatar. In this video, we're continuing my ranking series of all the benders. Or benders, well, the people have spoken, and y'all pick the animals. Moment of silence for all the Sutara shippers out there. Like last time, in the description you'll find a poll to vote for the next one. This time there will be three options, which are the villains, the relationships, and the spirits. Considering the tier list criteria, we'll be evaluating each animal from the perspective of how good they are in combat. How good they are in combat is based on a combination of skill, power, and advantageous abilities. Now, normally I do not rank those entries that I haven't seen enough in combat, but in this case I'll be a bit more lenient when it comes to the animals. If they have a certain ability that would logically be useful in battle, then I'll take that into account and rank them. Now, concerning the tiers, firstly we have not enough scratching. For the animals that just simply do not show enough combat or any combat prowess for them to be ranked. Then we have nuisance, trouble, brute, beast, giant, and finally the legendary tier. Before we start ranking, guys, please make sure to subscribe to the channel. It really helps support me and the channel, and I really appreciate it. Also, like this video and comment whether you agree with the ranking. Let's get roaring. In the none of scratching tier, we find a giant array of animals. The Avatar universe is simply filled to the brim with fauna that just exist and do not pose a threat to anyone. Because there's so many, we'll go through them a bit more quickly. Starting with Badger Frog, Gensmog Bull, Turtle Seal, Tiger Seal, Squirrel Frog, Koala Sheep, Damn Are They Cute, Hybrid Pigs, Ostrich Horse, Lion Vulture, Revaru, I Like His Babies, Is That Weird? I Don't Know, Other Penguin, Iguana Seal, Elephant Rat, possibly the coolest animal in the entire Avatar universe, Manatee Whale, Hippo Cow, Fox Antelope, Get Out, Cat, Possum Chicken, Elephant Koi, Koala Otter, oh my goodness, it's even cuter, Giant Rhinoceros Beetle, Dragon Moose, Singing Groundhog, Buffalo Yak, Art Fox Sloth, and finally our favorite widely adored bear, Dante Bosco. Okay, it's just Bosco. Okay, Bosco. So there they are, all the animals that show too little to be ranked. They are pretty much all awesome though, so they get an honorable mention. Which out of these animals is your favorite and would you like to have seen more of? Tell me in the comments. Okay, so then we continue in the nuisance tier. The first animal to enter the nuisance tier are the purple pentapus. With its 5 eyes and 5 tentacles, this creature lives in the sewers of Omashu. It latches onto its targets with its suction cups on its tentacles, leaving purple markings on their surfaces. And even though this process is entirely harmless, those bearing the purple markings might believe that they have a disease. In turn, the markings inspire fear in the opponents of the purple pentapus, which gives them a psychological advantage and may cause people to stay away from them. So in that way, these little creatures are pretty much ensuring their own survival. Also, they are pretty darn cute. Following the purple pentapus is the elbow leech. Found in the foggy swamp, the elbow leech attaches to people's elbows with its small mouth and then feeds on the host's blood. Though physically not very threatening, their method of feeding is quite disgusting. When attached, they also seem to require quite a bit of effort to pull off, as we see Toph do with Korra. The following entry is the sparrowkeet. Found in Bossing Say, the sparrowkeet is a small-sized green bird and can become quite angry if its food is eaten or disturbed. It's sure to be able to team up with other sparrowkeet and attack Momo after he ate their food. They are not incredibly capable, but they did disturb our favorite flying lemur with their screeching and beaks, so low nuisance tier. Following the sparrowkeet is one of the best animals in the entire universe, the turtle duck. Although they are mostly calm in nature, when provoked or if a mother's baby is in danger, it will fiercely attack the predator with its sharp beak. They are also known to flee from threats when they see one, like for example Azula's aura. Next up is a small fluffy white bird found in the foggy swamp, the screeching dodo. The screeching dodo appears harmless. However, though its beak is small when closed, it can open wide and release an intensely loud shriek, again festering fear in all enemies near it. Though physically not very capable, predators will surely think twice about coming close to this scary ass bird. Following the screeching dodo, we have the dragonfly. Dragonflies are good in teams and are shown to be quite a nuisance to the civilians of Bossing Say. When joined together, they are quite capable of harassing other creatures, especially humans. Their wings are quite weak though, a strong wind gust can easily disrupt their flight. Next up is a personal favorite of mine, the Saytu. The Saytu is a species of large green fish that is native to the rivers of the southern and western Earth Kingdom. It's at the top of the nuisance tier due to its epic battle with Sokka. The Saytu has shown to be incredibly agile and hard to catch. Also, hilariously, it is arrogant as f***, taunting their opponents with certain looks. Even when caught, they can use their tail to slap their enemy and release themselves from their grips. The Saytu gets a well-deserved spot here. Moving over to the Trouble tier, and the first sign of trouble in the Trouble tier is none other than Pabu, aka the Fire Ferrets. Not the team, like the actual animals. Though it is usually a friendly, non-aggressive animal, the Fire Ferret got something many other creatures don't. Intelligence. While obviously less capable in the physical realm, with its above average mental capacities, the Fire Ferret is a pretty capable opponent, though usually it is kept as a pet for Republic City citizens. Following the Fire Ferrets are a certain type of primate that inhabits the Earth Kingdom and the Fire Nation, the Hog Monkey. Hog monkeys usually roam in small packs, and a wild hog monkey is quite a troublesome creature, harassing its opponents and other creatures too. It's quite physically capable too, being very fast, mobile, and it brings sharp teeth and two tusks to battle. It does not, however, appear to be very intelligent. The succeeding entry is the pirate's favorite reptilian bird pet, the iguana parrot. Capable of flight, the iguana parrot is extremely agile, and it is quite threatening too with its sharp beaks and claws on the ends of its wings. The iguana parrot is quite a scary opponent to face, it even looks scary. It also doesn't really help that it is very temperamental in nature. In other words, don't f*** with this bird. Coming up is a creature that did f*** with the iguana parrot, our favorite flying lemur, Momo. Momo did not possess any incredible fighting skills. I mean, he was able to go toe-to-toe with the iguana parrot. But besides that, he helped Team Avatar out by fighting Fire Nation soldiers at times, though that mostly consisted of just jumping and bouncing on their heads. His ability to fly, though, helped him out here, as he was able to outmaneuver counterattacks and get to safety when necessary. He was also quite intelligent, able to unlock himself from cages. But that's it for Momo's combat prowess, a well-deserved spot here. Up next are the creatures that live in a Sea Wong Rock. This thing, the Buzzard Wasps. Though they primarily feed on creatures that have already passed out in the desert, they will attack those who enter their nests with quite a vicious attitude. One Buzzard Wasp was able to kidnap Momo, though granted, Momo was still kind of tripping his balls off. Anyway, they are considered pretty dangerous, especially when in their packs. All this lends them a spot just above Momo. Following the Buzzard Wasps is one of the zoo creatures in Ba Sing Se, the Tiger Dillo. Tiger Dillos are often highly aggressive in nature, attacking their opponents with claws and teeth bared. They show quite an offensive prowess in that sense. However, when faced with a counterattack, they are quick to curl up into a ball. But just like an armadillo, the Tiger Dillo has great defensive power, as its skin is a natural shield against enemies' attacks, and it hides the animal's vulnerable spots. Moving on, the final animal making it to the trouble tier is the Wolf Bat. Again, not the team, just the animal. Wolfbats are incredibly fast and use its wings to fly, giving it great aerial mobility. But besides its great mobility, they also have sharp pointed teeth that make them quite a threatening opponent. They are shown to be precise in their attacks, able to get rid of a burning torch in a person's hands with ease. Besides that, when threatened, they can swiftly get to safety due to their speed and their wings. Overall, the Wolfbat is quite a threat to face. No wonder the best pro bending team made it their mascot. Now, we move over to the Brute Tier, and the first animal gracing the Brute Tier with its presence is the Elephant Mandrill. Found in the Earth Kingdom, the Elephant Mandrill is usually a peaceful animal. Yet, when angered, its size and speed make it a very dangerous creature when it attacks civilians or other animals. Though not really known to bite its opponents, it can stomp over them by accident or with intention. A pretty scary creature solely due to its size and weight. Following the Elephant Mandrill, we encounter another foggy swamp resident, this time being the Cat Gator. This large dark green reptile has a set of sharp teeth with which they can bite into their opponents. Its intimidating appearance scares off many predators. When provoked, he is known to threaten humans. He also has a camouflage ability, making himself look like a tree branch in the water to make unsuspecting targets enter his vicinity, only to then subsequently use his sharp teeth to attack its target. Besides, in the water, his speed allows him to chase his targets. He is, however, easily outclassed by a bigger creature like Appa. Up next is the mount that transported Sokka, Suki, and Toph towards Ozai's airship base. As Pyondao explained,
nothing runs faster over land or swims quicker than a giant eel hound.
During the introduction, I said we had to take some liberties here and there, and yeah, we never really see the eel hound in battle or fight anything really. However, it is the fastest on the ground and in the water, so logically it is probably very hard to attack. It is also said to be very difficult to tame. Tamed eel hounds are apparently very rare, so that's an after effect for you. Next up is an animal frequently used as cavalry mounts during the Hundred Year War, most prominently used by the Rough Rhinos, the most advanced singing group in the history of the Fire Nation. Of course, we're talking about the Komodo Rhinos. These giant mounts have incredibly tough skin, serving as natural protection for their body. Beside its great natural defense, the Komodo Rhino enters battle with large horns on its face and two more coming from its forehead. These horns are able to pierce through wood, and it's also pretty fast. Overall, the Komodo Rhino has many advantages. The thing keeping it from entering the highest tiers, however, is its intelligence. Without a human mounting it, The Komodo rhino seems clueless on what to do and just keeps walking in a straight line. It is also easily confused by opponents when hit by something or someone. All in all, it's a powerful animal that doesn't really live up to its potential. Now we move over to the beast tiers. Here we're going to find some crazy animals that are highly threatening and very powerful. And the first animal in the beast tier is the platypus bear. Found in the forests and valleys of the Earth Kingdom, a wild platypus bear is very aggressive. It has incredible strength and uses its claws and its tail to attack. Its attacks are capable of making great dents into trees, and it can easily break a cart full of cabbages.
Security!
We did see, however, that the platypus bear is scared off by larger predators like flying bison, laying an egg in the process. Though, admittedly, the platypus bear is not very likely to come across predators larger in size than itself. Fun fact, a platypus bear's favorite food is the arrogant Seitu fish. Alright, that's it. Next up is the Kenyan crawler. Found in the Western Earth Kingdom and more commonly in the worst episode of the universe, the Kenyan crawler has a very sensitive nose, allowing it to smell out its predators. It is a very dangerous opponent to face. Not only does it look very intimidating, but its powerful jaws allow it to end its prey quickly. Besides that, they are quick and they have the ability to scale on walls. And they hold up defensively too, as in they can take a hit and they are not easily scared off. All in all, the Kenyan crawler is a really potent predator and an ugly one at that. Moving on, the next entry on the list is another bear, but this time a polar bear dog, Naga. Serving as Korra's animal companion, Naga is an adorable polar bear dog and a lovely pet. However, don't mistake her kindness for a weakness. She's a very fast and, more importantly, strong animal. She showed to be able to destroy the bars of a jail cell, remove the door of a car, swat the lieutenant while in mid-air, and she was even able to pull 3 mechatanks away from Bolin, subsequently destroying them. She also has a noteworthy amount of speed, able to catch up with cars. So yeah, Naga is a very potent threat, though mostly she's just a very sweet butter bear dog. The final animal in the beast tier is another pet, though this time being Boomies, the goat gorilla Flopsy. Generally, goat gorillas are extremely hostile, confronting and ramming their opponents until they fall to the ground. Their massive arms give them a lot of offensive prowess, allowing them to break stone. Goat gorillas are surprisingly fast too, almost capable of outrunning Aang, which is not a small feat.
You see, I have very large feet.
Furthermore!
Another noteworthy attribute is that, well, they're giant. And, I mean, being really big gives you a lot of advantage offensively and defensively. All in all, Flopsy and goat gorillas in general are incredibly scary animals to face. Though when they're pets, they are more cute than dangerous. And now we arrive at the giant tier. And the first animal in the giant tier is none other than the porcupine. One of the coolest animals shown in perhaps the most epic animal fight is the porcupine. When adult, the porcupine is extremely bad-tempered and dangerous. Now, obviously what makes the porcupine so powerful is the fact that its entire body is covered in quills. This basically means that even though an opponent might get a hit on the porcupine, they are always hurt themselves as the quills latch onto an opponent upon physical contact. In the fight with Appa, the porcupine nearly won from the 10-ton flying bison, inflicting great damage on him using his quills. Not only did the quills inflict a lot of damage, but the porcupine was also able to thrust Appa against a tree, displaying amazing strength. The porcupine gets a worthy spot in the giant tier, though the animals that follow it are still clearly more powerful. The next animal is the biggest one so far, the saber-toothed moose lion. Though friendly in nature when not threatened, when it is in danger or its cub is endangered, you do not want to stand before this beast. With a great pair of antlers on its head and 2 spiky tusks, the saber-toothed moose lion is a huge threat. And then its size, this giant creature can just sprint towards you and crush you with ease if it wants. The saber-toothed moose lion gets a well-deserved spot here. Up next are the first benders on this tier list, the sky bison. As illustrated by our favorite 10-ton monster, Appa, the original airbenders are extremely powerful. First of all, they are giant. This usually already gives them an upper hand in battle as they're not easily knocked over or staggered. Their size and their 6 arms give them incredible strength too. We see Appa lifting Fire Nation Thunder Tanks with ease. When fighting humans, we see Appa skip Short Fang like the little skipping stone shit he is. Not only are they strong, but Sky Bison can airbend too. They usually use the flick of their tail to create powerful gusts of air, which we see Appa do several times, as well as the wild sky bison who was able to airbend a heavy metal car. And besides all that, true to their name, sky bison can fly. Their flight allows them to avoid attacks and get to the high ground and retreat if necessary. Though usually they'll win the battle in the first place. All in all, the skill set of the sky bison is tremendous. The second to last creature making it to the giant tier is one of the best designed animals in my opinion. found in the Earth Kingdom and June's favorite tracking buddy, the Sheer Shoe. I mean, let's start off with the fact that it is the best tracker in the entire Avatar universe. The Sheer Shoe sees with its mole-like nose and can detect any specific scent and track it over the entire world. A Sheer Shoe will always know where his enemy is hiding, giving it an outstanding advantage in battle. However, its nose being its eyes also gives it a critical weakness. Okay, so apart from its smell, the Sheer Shoe has another ability, of course, which is its tongue. Or more specifically, its saliva. A Sheer Shoe's saliva contains highly powerful toxins. And when it finds itself in close combat, it'll whip its tongue out several meters and fully paralyze its opponent with its own saliva. Which is kind of disgusting, actually. Anyway, the toxins in its saliva are so powerful that Nyla, June's Sheer Shoe, even showed to be capable of fully paralyzing Appa. And even though it is nearly as large as a Sky Bison, the Sheer Shoe's agility is superb as well. All in all, the Sheer Shoe is an amazing creature and a great combatist. The only thing really keeping it from legendary is the fact that, well, it has a weakness. And the creatures above the Sheer Shoe are on another level. The final entry in the giant tier are the original Earthbenders, the Badger Moles. Just like the Sheer Shoe, these creatures have a different form of seeing. They see with their earthbending, eventually teaching Toph the same technique. And their earthbending is incredibly powerful. Using their paws, Badger Moles are capable of making giant tunnels underground, and their sheer size also give them a huge advantage in battle. All in all, the Badger Moles are tremendously powerful creatures, and they really deserve this spot. And here we are, ladies and gentlemen, the legendary tier. In this tier, we'll find the biggest, most powerful creatures that roam the earth of Avatar. And the first creature entering the legendary tier is the Serpent from the Serpent's Pass. In their quest to transport a pregnant couple to Ba Sing Se, the gang was forced to tread in the territory of this giant snake boy. The Serpent is a very ferocious creature. It is pretty much hostile to anything it encounters. With its giant body, the Serpent can wrap itself around an entire ship and eat up every single human on it. Though not having the most unique design, for some reason, the Serpent made an appearance in the unaired pilot too. Look, there he is, better than ever. And it also came up in the chibi shorts, which are weirdly good, by the way. Anyway, its giant size gives it a spot in the legendary tier. Next up are another set of original benders. Dragons. Being the original firebenders, the dragons are capable of producing incredible amounts of fire. They are even capable of producing multicolored flames, as illustrated by Ren and Shaw. Not only are they offensively capable, but they also have incredible mobility due to their flight. Dragons are shown to be exceptionally agile in the air, giving them a great advantage in battle by swiftly attacking or retreating. Furthermore, dragons have a body made of scales, giving them a natural shield against enemy attacks. Taking everything into account, dragons are amazingly powerful creatures, and they get a well-deserved third place. Moving over to the following entry, we have the Kyoshi Island's personal giant eel, the Unagi. The Unagi is a gigantically powerful eel. Its size alone makes it one of the biggest threats in the Avatar universe. It is incredibly fast in the water, easily able to catch up to its prey, which usually include elephant koi, and a badly animated Aang. Its mouth is equipped with a giant set of sharp teeth, allowing it to eat its prey. And beside its giant teeth, the Unagi can stun its prey by emitting very powerful water blasts. So I wonder, is the Unagi a waterbender or not? Let me know in the comments what you think. Regardless, the Unagi is incredible, easily deserving a spot in the second place. The final spot is the biggest and most ancient animal in the entire Avatar universe, found throughout the world of Avatar, the lion turtle. These ginormous creatures granted people the power of bending in the first place. They were so big that they housed entire cities. Each lion turtle was associated with one of the four elements, and they held those powers. Lion turtles associated with air could even fly. They were also capable of energy bending, ultimately teaching Aang this ability to defeat Ozai. They are also intelligent, capable of speech and understanding other human languages. Their sheer size and ability to bend their respective element and energy bend gives these ancient creatures the most powerful spot of all time in the legendary tier. So that was it. Thanks for watching, guys. Do you agree with my ranking? What animal do you think should be higher on the list? And what animal do you think should be lower on the list? What animal did I get just right? I'm eager to know your thoughts. Don't forget to like the video and vote for the poll, that really helps me out. And subscribe to the channel if you want to join the club. Have a good one. See ya.